Hey, it's Becky. Today, I'm listening to satellites by building and testing this super simple tape measure Yagi antenna.
This video is sponsored by HamRadioPrep.com. My take on this classic design uses pieces of standard tape measure steel as radials, a 1-inch diameter PVC pipe as the mast, and 3D printed couplers to link the radials to the mast. I modeled the couplers using Tinkercad, first by creating stand-ins for both the mast and the tape measure, then forming solids to join the two, and grouping everything together. After making this long version, I shortened it so the couplers could be closer together on the mast, and created a few versions for the end cap and the driven element couplers. I printed the rainbow of parts on my Creality CR10S Pro. I posted the file so you can download and print your own. I followed the 2 meter band specs I found online for the length and spacing of the tape measure pieces. I'm far from the first person to make one of these, and I'll put links to all of my research sources in the description. For the junction of the driven elements, I sanded off the paint from the tape measure steel where I wanted to solder and connected the driven elements with a piece of wire bent into a hairpin shape, as well as the two different parts of the coaxial cable. I'm using a software-defined radio USB dongle to connect the antenna to my computer running Cubic SDR, a free app that's cross-platform and open source.
Inside Cubic SDR, I can see a waterfall display of the spectrum, and I can move around to look at and listen to different frequencies. If you're new to this setup, play around with the small dipole antenna that comes with the SDR unit first. You can tune to your local favorite FM radio station to start, or try finding your local NOAA weather broadcast station, which will also supply a constant source of audio.
9 to 10 knots. Seas 1 foot or less for tonight.
Then try to tune to your local repeaters, which will only be visible on the display and, you know, audible when they are transmitting, which isn't necessarily all of the time. What's cool about using the waterfall display for tracking satellite signals is that it visualizes the Doppler effect, making it easier to stay tuned to the right frequency as it changes slightly during the satellite's rise and set. You can also see the visualization of the signal get brighter when the antenna is pointed in the right direction.
Once I got up on the roof, I remembered to tape the ends of the cut pieces of tape measure for safety. I don't want to put anybody's eye out. And I used the Heavens Above Android app to look up and track satellites with downlinks operating in that 2 meter band and had a go at pointing the antenna while setting the frequency on the computer. It's hard to do both at the same time, so I got some help. We didn't really get any results the first time out, so I borrowed a friend's Nano VNA to try to check and tune the standing wave ratio of my antenna. I first set it to sweep between 144 and 148 megahertz, then calibrated it using the included open, short, and load nubbins. I tuned my antenna by adjusting the spacing between the driven elements and the shape of the hairpin wire. We're going for as close to 1 as can be managed here. Back up to the roof to try again.
Okay, so I'm looking for satellites that are passing as close to straight overhead as possible, at least not down towards the horizon, because obviously there's too many buildings in the way. And I'm also looking for satellites with a downlink or a telemetry beacon in that 2 meter band.
The satellites I ended up being able to hear the best were NOAA weather satellites, which transmit an analog picture signal containing satellite images that can be decoded from the recorded audio file. My best attempt at this so far had a small area that wasn't static, but you can see with the map overlay and compared to the full satellite image I looked up online, I've got a real partial result here. It's so cool that signal came from space. Here's my best non-weather satellite pass so far. You can start to hear something in the static, though it's not decipherable. The next thing I'd like to do, besides continue to tune this antenna, is to add another set of radials for the 70 centimeter band, so I can cover the other most common satellite frequencies and even start to talk in addition to listening.
While you don't have to have a ham radio license to do anything I just showed you, maybe you'd like to get one or upgrade the one you've got. That's where the sponsor for this video comes in, hamradioprep.com. You can get 20% off your purchase of any of their online courses with my discount code. I'll put a link in the description. While there are other free ham study options out there, Ham Radio Prep offers some learning features that really work for me, like highlighting material from the manual that's included in the current exam question set. Plus, they offer a money-back guarantee and high-quality practice exams, so you can be confident you're ready to take the real thing. In addition to studying for my general, I'm also taking their Baofeng Basics course to get better acquainted with my handheld radio. Thanks again to hamradioprep.com for supporting this channel. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with a friend. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.